Welcome to Unfold Data Science, friends. My name is Aman and I am a data scientist. In this particular video, we are going to understand what is curse of dimensionality in very simple language, okay? So this is how you have to explain to someone to make sure that your understanding of the topic is very sound. Let's start, guys. First of all, let us take a simple use case. So you have to predict house price. So if I tell you in Bangalore, India, can you predict the house price of a house given some input features? So what are the input features you will ask me? You will tell me, hey Aman, there are no features, so how can I train the model? Give me some features, right? So maybe few features you will take as number of bedrooms, right, in the house. Number of bedrooms. Maybe you will ask me what is the locality, right? Maybe you will ask me whether it is an apartment or individual house. So you will ask me this information as well. Maybe you will ask me on which floor the house is. Let us say number of floor. So you will ask me this information which you feel is relevant for the learning, which you feel is relevant for the model to generalize a phenomena. What is the purpose of entire machine learning, guys? The purpose is to output a model. What is a model? A model is a generalized thing which can be used to predict the house price, right? Now, if you give all these information to these models, right, the model is going to get more and more information about the pattern in the data, correct? But what happens if we keep adding on many variables? For example, these are my independent feature. Of course, the target feature is my house price. Let us say I add here number of, movie theaters nearby. Okay. I add a variable here and call that variable as how many parks are there nearby. Okay. I add a variable and call this as what is the population density in that particular area. Okay. I add one more variable here and I may call that how many shopping malls are in the nearby area. Shopping malls in nearby area. How many offices are in nearby area. So what is happening here is we are adding more and more information to the training process. So we are telling to the model, hey, you know what? I have this information for you as well. Now try to understand what will happen here, guys, okay? For example, if I tell you the price of a two-bedroom flat is 20. Forget the unit for now. Price of a two-bedroom flat is 20, three-bedroom flat is 30. Now this looks like a very simple equation, right? Tomorrow I ask you what is the price of a four-bedroom flat. Very simply, model can say me 40, correct? But normally in machine learning, use cases are not this simple in real world, right? So we add little more features, little more knowledge. Let us include one more variable here. One more variable is it an apartment or it's an individual house? Or this one you can take, locality, okay? At the moment I add this apartment flag here, so this is an apartment and this is not an apartment. Okay, something like this. Now what will happen here is there is more information to learn for the model, which might not be very useful for this prediction. Okay, so this is your number of bedrooms. This is your target variable, which is nothing but house price. And this is your apartment feature. Okay, here the learning can be very simple using these two only. But if I add one more feature here, it is not much useful. I am giving you simple example with one, two features, but in real world, up to 20, 30, 40 features, it is useful for the model. But if you increase it like 100, 200, 500, those features might not add much value to the model. And that is what we call curse of dimensionality. How do you explain this in interview, or how do you explain it to someone? Suppose there is a model one, okay? Model 1 is having how many features? 10 features. There is a model 2. Model 2 is having how many features? 20 features. Model 3 is having how many features? 30 features. Model 4, how many features? 40 features, okay? So, it is quite possible that Model 1 is poor than Model 2 in terms of prediction power. 10 variables is not strong enough for the prediction, whereas 20 variables is creating lot of difference. So, M2 is a better model than M1. But, not always true that since we are adding 10 more variables here, so M3 will be a better model than M2. Similarly, since I am adding 10 more variables here, so M4 will be a better model than M3. Not always true. And also, how it hampers the model's learning, that I am going to tell you with a simple example. Okay? So here, suppose this is 2, 3, 20, 10, 20, 30 and 0, 1. If you give only this much of data, model's life is easy, right? So model will just see, okay, the pattern is like this multiplied by 10. If you give one more feature, model will confuse a little bit, right? Now imagine a scenario of guys k-means clustering, okay? So in k-means clustering, if I have to cluster the houses in, let's say, high value houses or medium value houses or low value houses, something like that, then these two features will be useful. But if you plot an n-dimensional graph like this, right, up to 2-dimension, 3-dimension, it's okay to calculate the Euclidean distance or Manhattan distance in k-means clustering. But if you keep on adding more and more features, right, the calculation of the distance, whether Euclidean, Manhattan, in k-nearest neighbor, you do some distance calculation, right? All those models where you do those calculations, adding more and more feature will make those calculations complex. And what will happen due to that? Model's generalization will not be proper. So what is curse of dimensionality by definition? By definition, curse of dimensionality is all the phenomena that occurs because of high dimensions in the data. One phenomena is model cannot generalize the underlying pattern. Second phenomena is model can overfit. Third phenomena, model can underfit sometimes. Fourth phenomena, model might not be able to utilize important features as well. Suppose this is an important feature and you give some non-important features, right? Model will not be able to utilize this also due to impact coming from other features. So this is how curse of dimensionality works, guys. In real world, why this topic is important is, in real world you will have many data sets where you will have many features. Suppose tomorrow you start working in a project, you will collect as much as features you want, as much as features, because we don't know which features are more important, which are less important, right? So we collect many features, but end of it, we have to reduce it and bring it to a level which makes sense for the learning. So here I will stop at M2. Here I will not give one additional feature, and all those techniques, right? Feature elimination, forward elimination, backward elimination, recursive feature elimination, some feature reduction like principal component analysis, factor analysis, all those things revolve around curse of dimensionality only. So what is the purpose of machine learning and model building, guys? Keep it generic. Keep it as simple as possible. And it should also have good prediction power. To find that balance, right, we need more knowledge, but not at the cost of overfitting, not at the cost of confusing the model, not at the cost of, you know, not able to use the model in production. So this entire topic is around that balance, guys. So I hope you understood what is curse of dimensionality. It is nothing but where do you find that sweet spot? Where do you find that threshold? In this case, M2 is your threshold. You do not go beyond 20 features. So I'm also going to tell you in my upcoming videos, how do you choose these 20 features, right? So few techniques I have explained like RFE and others. I am going to explain some more techniques in my upcoming video. Let me know what doubts you have, guys. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Please drop a comment with all your questions, doubts, queries. I'll see you all in the next video, guys. Till then, wherever you are, stay safe and take care.